Good afternoon, YouTube. So this is the automatic door closer on my garage access door. I repaired this arm up here a few years ago, welded this in and recut the square hole, but over the years this side here looks like it's fatigued and it broke. So I'm thinking what I'm going to do is I'll bend this back together, close the square hole up, and then I'm going to weld some strips of metal on each side to widen it out. And wider is no problem there. And then I think it's a little bit thin. So what I might do is run a weld bead around the hole again to thicken it up. And then I'll grind it back to the thickness of that square stud that sticks up there. So I may have thin this out a little bit when I ground the previous welding out. But yeah, let's clean this up. I'll grind off all the paint, get down to some clean metal, and then see if we can bend this back together. I've got all the paint off, and I think what happened is this thinner side has stretched a little bit before it failed. And so what I've been doing is I ground out where the crack was, and then just to take off a little bit, I'm running it through the bandsaw blade here. And the idea is I want to take out some material there, so I go over to the vise and hammer this side in to close up that crack, and then test fit it on the square stud. So I probably have to do it a few more times here. Okay, I think we got it there. Took a couple more passes, just take a cut, hammer it closed, and right now it won't quite fit on the square stud. Anyway, the plan is to see if I can weld these two little slivers of metal on the side, kind of double up the thickness there. Okay, gonna give this a try. So I recut my pieces of metal. I ground off the mill scale before I sliced them off. I put the little bit thicker piece over here. So I'll turn my welder down to the lowest heat, like the 1/8-inch sheet metal setting. Okay, I think we got her welded in there. I kind of tack welded the ends, took off the vise grips, and then ran around the top and the bottom. So I'm still letting it cool right now, still a little warm. Okay, we're getting pretty close on the hole. So I have this triangular file that's just a bit smaller than the square stud on the door closer. So you can work it through the flat sides there. And I'm getting pretty close. The stud is about 370 thousandths. A little short there. That one's pretty close, but right there, that side, I'm a little bit short on. I'm gonna go chuck that back up in the vise and see if we can get this top to bottom on this side a little bit bigger, and I think it'll fit. But now I've got a pretty nice square hole in there and about twice as much metal as it was before. So a little more work. So I gotta file out this side right here, and then we can go take a look at it. Okay, I think that does it. Got a really nice tight fit on the stud up there. There's no wobble at all. And I'm actually moving the closer when I rock it. So when you put it back together, you need the arm straight out when the door is closed. And let's take a look here, see if it actually works. You can pop it open. Closes. Yeah, there we go. I think that'll work. But yeah, I think that's the trick. Just thicken up the metal around the sides. Keep filing the hole out until it just barely fits over that stud. And then I also built up the thickness of the arm so that it's a little bit taller than the stud. See this thickness right here? That's the height of that. There's a shoulder up to the top of the square part, and that's where the screw goes in.
and clamps everything down.
So as the metal stretched, it got thinner, and then that's what led to it being loose, because the arm itself is a bit thicker than that stud. So I'm thinking maybe the metal, as it stretched, it got thinner, which made it loose, which made it wobble more and put more stress on it. So it's just kind of a vicious circle. Maybe when I repaired it last time, I left it a little bit thin, because by the time you grind off the paint and the mill scale and get down to clean metal, it's a little bit thinner. So yeah, if you have any questions about that repair, post up in the comments section below. And as always, thanks for watching.